I just realized that one of the videos I filmed yesterday had no audio, so that's great. What's up, guys? Nerdy Noob here, and welcome to another unboxing video. I made sure the audio worked on this one before I started filming. In this video, we're going to be unboxing this box. Ta-da! This is the official Stan Lee box. Bam! This box is, it's been okay. I think this is the third or fourth one that we received. I don't remember how often they ship. I want to say it's definitely not monthly, because I don't think I get this box monthly. Probably maybe bi-monthly or quarterly, or I don't really know. Anyways, if you're interested in getting this box, I'm going to put all of the pricing details in the description below for you. Once you remove the box from the other box that it gets shipped in and you open it up, this is what you're gonna see. Alright, so the one reason that this box hasn't been the greatest thing in the world is because this box claims that they're an official Stan Lee box. It's basically like filled with items that Stan Lee curated or whatever it is, but this box has yet to really blow us away with a lot of exclusives. So what they've been doing is giving us a lot of products, but products that you can get on Amazon. So I want to say the last box was not bad. It had good value, I think. The first box was kind of like, eh. I'm not quite sure how this box is going to do, so let's go ahead and check it out. The first item we have is this pillow. I don't know if it's going to be a month of pillows, but this is another box with another pillow. This is a pillow that has Stan Lee on it, and it says Excelsior. It's not like a super, super awesome, nice pillow. It's just a little square pillow. Nothing too fancy with that. This is our recap card, I think. Yes, so we set that to the side. We have our item that's in this cardboard envelope, which is usually a bunch of comic books and whatnot. Let's see what is inside. More stickers. They keep giving us a lot of stickers. All right, here we go. The first comic book that we have, we got two versions of the same comic book. We got the colored variant and the black and white variant. This is Secret Empire, Captain America Lives Again. So there are the different options right there. This is our colored one. This is our black and white. Both of these are priced at $4.99. These are specific to the box. So these are Stan Lee box exclusives, if you can see the little symbol right there. So that's very cool. I do like how they give us both variants, so you don't have to hope that you're going to get one or the other, but that we get both. As a collector, that's cool. The next item we'll get is Stan Lee's God Woke. I don't know what this is about. So this is some kind of like maybe a graphic novel. It's an actual book, and it's a pretty thick book. And the graphics are really nice. The colors pop really well off these pages. I don't exactly know what this is about. Kind of has an odd mixture of things. Like, just this page alone is a little bit confusing. If you can see it, there's like Albert Einstein and stuff, JFK. Okay, so there's that. This is also a Stan Lee box exclusive. So this box, apparently they wanted to give us a lot of exclusive items after I made a comment that there wasn't enough. They're proving me wrong. The next item we have is a mug. This is a white mug. I think that this is Stan Lee and his wife. I know his wife just passed away, like, not that long ago. But that's what I'm gonna go with. Maybe that's him paying homage to her. Next, we got a pair of socks. These are called Dead Socksy. Not quite sure what these have to do with Stan Lee or Marvel. Maybe these are socks that he wears. They're nice socks. They're made in Dallas. They're definitely nice quality socks. These are like the fancy socks that you'd wear with fancy shoes. But I don't exactly know what purpose they hold, you know? Or not what purpose they hold, but like what in what connection does it have with this box? We got our Stan Lee trading card right here. If you want to read it, you can pause that and read it. And then we got this item. I don't know what this is. Is this some kind of reusable bag, maybe? Oh. This is kind of funny. This is a reusable bag, but it's not a regular reusable bag. It's actually a reusable backpack. So I've never seen anything like this. So interesting. You have Stanley's face on here. There's Velcro when you pull it up, and that's what leads to the bag opening. So it's like in this situation, it's almost like a regular bag, but there's straps on the back to make it a backpack. So here's the design on the, once you put the Stan Lee flap up, that's what the design is. The bag is not as wide, or I don't know how you'd say it, but it doesn't open up as much as a regular reusable bag. It's a little bit thinner, but this has backpack straps, which is so interesting. I've literally, like, what an interesting idea to have a reusable bag backpack. Like, this is not the most comfortable thing, though. I will say, it's a little bit odd. Definitely not padded on the back to be like a really good backpack. I can feel these like straps digging into my skin, but it's a good little concept. It's kind of interesting. It's an interesting concept. This is the first time I've ever seen a reusable backpack. So basically a backpack made from a bag that's kind of one of those like reusable bags. Interesting. That's interesting. They might have something going on there, like a good idea happening. He's got his new comic book box. For those of you who like comic books, this might actually be a good... It's expensive. I want to say I looked into it and it was kind of pricey. But you're going to get... Oh, it's $20 a month. But you're going to get, I think, new books in that. So that's kind of a cool thing if you're really into Marvel comics. That might be a good idea for you. Apparently you can get a Spider-Man flash drive? 10% off, but it's at some kind of eBay store. I don't know how that's working out. I don't know why they would drive us to go shop at an eBay store since this is the official Stan Lee box. Okay, I'm sweating. I gotta turn my fan on. I don't know what's going on with me. I can't, like, my temperature's been all over the place. All right, so that's all the items in the box. Let's go ahead and do some pricing and recap. Here's our card. I think the theme might have been summer love again. Yeah, so... I'm assuming that this might have been a box that was somewhat dedicated to his wife. What's the most sad about this, I think, is that with these boxes, they have to plan these boxes pretty far in advance. And I want to say that prior to his wife passing away, they probably created this box because it says that this year he's going to be celebrating his 70th wedding anniversary with his wife. And it's just kind of like... I don't know. That kind of sucks, but summer love was the theme. So the first item that we have, where is our calculator? I just pulled this out thinking it was my calculator, but it's a Blu-ray of Doctor Strange. So that's, yeah. Good one, Steph. Good one. All right, here we go. First item we have was this little trading card with the little card protector. I don't really know. Like, this is almost like their pin. You know, boxes have pins. I don't know what I'm supposed to give that because it's not, I don't know if you, I don't think this has any value, but I'll be really nice and give it $1. There was some stickers in there. You know what? I'm gonna add the stickers and that card, and that's what's gonna get $1 just to make it work. These two comic books, it's the Secret Empire number one variants. These are each priced at $4.99, so I definitely think I could give each of these $5. Now these are exclusive, so they added Stan Lee under the cover. That's so funny. It says also on this sensational cover, Stan Lee. That's neat. I think because these are variants, you probably could give maybe $1 extra. I know my pricing for comics have been a little bit all over the place because I'm still trying to learn about them. I wouldn't mind giving each of these $6, though, because they are exclusive to this box. For now, I'm just going to go ahead and keep these at the $5 list price, but I think you could give them $6 more. I've been on the hunt for variant comics in the past, and yeah, I've paid a lot more than list price for them. So we'll just keep those at the $5 price point each. But again, I think you could probably give those six. Next, we have this Stan Lee pillow. Again, this is themed off of Grease. Sorry, I did not pick that up. Although I should have because I was wondering why he looked like that. They basically put his head on the Fonz's body, so that's great. I love how big his head is and compared to the body. This pillow is cool. It's not the greatest pillow in the world. I probably would give this anywhere from maybe $6 to $8. I don't even know if I want to give this thing $7 just because it's really not. Like, the only thing that's good about it is that Stan Lee's on it. And it doesn't even have anything to say that it's an official licensed product or anything like that. So this, potentially, anybody could make a pillow like this and sell it just kind of like an in-house product, I would probably, let's give this $6. That might be a little bit low, but I really don't want to give, I don't want to overprice that because it's not like the greatest item in the world. We had our exclusive Stanley backpack. This backpack is ridiculous. So it's made out of reusable bags, like the same material that reusable bags have. If I had to give this a price point, I would probably give this maybe like $5 at most. Usually reusable bags are about $1 or $2, and then this one's a little bit bigger, and then it's a backpack, and it has Stan Lee, so I feel like $5 would be pretty decent. You might be able to give it $6. I think that'd be pushing it for what it actually is, so I'm just gonna keep it at $5. Next, we have our Stan Lee and Joanie Forever Collectible Glassware. So we got the mug, but there's actually two different options. There was either the mug or a glass. Between the two, I don't really know which one I prefer. I like mugs, so I'm okay with it. Although I've received so many mugs that it's kind of beyond the point where I can even like use all the mugs I receive, but I do enjoy that. Would have been even cooler if it was a color-changing mug. If I had to price that, I would probably give that... I usually give mugs, what, $5 or $6? I'll give that. If it's $5 or $6 in-house, I'll give it $6.50. We have our Stanley's God Woke. I have no idea what this even is. Honestly, there's like, the pricing online is really weird. So I would probably give this anywhere from $10 to $12. I think $12 would be the highest that I would go. There's no price listed on here, so I don't really know what this is worth. It's an exclusive to this box. I don't think this is something, I don't know if this is something they sell in the store. I'm not quite sure. So let's go ahead and give it 10 for now. And I would probably say that you could probably give that a few extra dollars. But let's just do a 10. And then the last item we have was our exclusive Dead Soxy socks. These are another, it says Stan Lee socks. I guess Stan Lee probably likes to wear these, I would say. They say they're exclusive, but I don't really, there's no like exclusive sticker, so I don't know how exclusive that really is. Here's the one thing I'm going to say about these socks. Like I said, they are fancy. They're fancy socks. These are not the same type of socks that we just get in our boxes, you know, like ones that companies make or even like the Marvel socks. These are like fancy, nice socks. Now, I went on their website, and they are costing anywhere from $15 to $22 a pair. If you were to, I guess, go online and buy it for that price, then if that's the value, I would never pay that much for socks. I feel like these are the type of socks that you could go to TJ Maxx or Marshall's after the fact when they've kind of, you know, maybe a little bit older of a style and get them. I would probably give these $7 to $10. I think 10 is more realistic, but I feel ridiculous pricing these socks at so much higher than what I normally price socks, but I don't know. Let's give it 8, which I think is already, I usually give socks like 5 or 6 or 7 or 8. So let's give it 8 on the higher end of what I usually price socks at. You, like I said, these are socks that from this company are going for $15 to $22 on their website. So it just depends on how you want to price them, but I'm going to go ahead and give those, what did I say? I'll give them 8. These are inspired by Spidey, just so you guys know. Okay, so that's all the items in the box. According to my pricing, this box is worth $46.50. Just want to point out that these socks are going on eBay for like $6 to $8. So this is supposed to be a bi-monthly box, although the last box I got was in April. So maybe this was for June. I don't really know. Anyways, this box cost $58 per box. But I bought the annual, so I'm paying $54 a box. Okay, so maybe I'm just really off in my pricing because that's not good. If it's $54 for this box, I didn't hit my value by $7.50. So let's like go back and look. I did say that you could potentially add $1 each for the variant comic. So if we did that, add 2. The bag, I really don't want to give the bag any more money. We might be able to give it one more dollar. It's not like a really fancy, nice backpack or anything. It's literally a reusable bag with straps for a backpack. The glass, what did I give that? $6, $7, $8? I don't remember. Let's just give the glass one more dollar. The socks, we could give $2 more and give it $10. I think that is overpriced because, like I said, on eBay, you can get them pretty cheap now, these specific ones. The God Woke, if we added what, I gave it 10, you might be able to give it 12, maybe 15. I think 15 would definitely be, I think 15 might be overpriced. Let's be nice though and give it 15, so we had 5. And then maybe we had one more dollar for the pillow. That gives us $4.50 extra value on top of what we paid for it. So still at the end of the day, even if I were to price these a little bit higher, it's still not hitting the value that we want for a $54 box. We want at least $15 extra value. So I think what this box needs is, one, it needs one more item. It did come with a good amount of items, except for if you think of it, like, this doesn't count as an item, the card. So it had, you know, the 2 comic books, the backpack, the pillow, the book, the socks, and a glass. I think that this box needs one more item that's exclusive, which they did say everything was exclusive. That makes sense. But maybe like an exclusive Funko Pop or something that's going to give this box maybe $10 to $15 more value. It definitely is low on the value. That is for sure. And I'm also confused about the month of this box, because I think it's actually July. It got shipped at the end, like the almost the end of July. But like I said, the last box I got was April, so I don't really know. It does say bi-monthly though. If I had to rate this box, I didn't like this one at all. I liked the last one a lot better. I don't even really remember, but I remember liking it a lot better than this one. I feel bad for saying that because obviously this box again was based off of their summer love and all that, and I don't want to sound like a jerk. The items are okay. I think that there's some items that I think are really good and should stay in the box, and there's some items that I think they're doing a little bit too much, like the pillow and the reusable bag backpack. That's not I don't plan to find items like that in this kind of box. Like, if one-up box or somebody gave us that kind of item, I'd be like, oh, okay, that makes sense. But I feel like this box can be doing a lot better and a lot more with the connections they have. And that's one of the things I'm most disappointed about. I'm getting items that are like, first of all, I feel like they just did some kind of brand deal with this company, because it has nothing to do with, I don't know. I keep in my mind thinking it has nothing to do with Marvel, but at the end of the day, this isn't a Marvel box, it's a Stan Lee box. So I guess maybe, since it, maybe he, because it's Spidey colors, it's somehow connected to Stan Lee. I'm not quite sure. But yeah, I was not a fan of this box. If I had to rate it, I would probably give this box, I'd probably give it a 2.75 out of 5 noobs. Again, it's like nice items, but I just don't really understand. It's not the type of items that I necessarily expected to see in a box like this. That's all. I don't know. I'm not quite sure. Some of these items would be good for like the Marvel Home Goods box that Loot Crate does. Alright guys, that's all I have for you in this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, feel free to click the like button below. If you want to see more unboxing videos, go check out my channel. I have a whole bunch on there. And you should subscribe. Let me know in the comment section below what you guys thought about this box. What are your thoughts? I think I just don't have much to say about it, but let me know what you think about it down below. And remember, if you subscribe to my channel and your subscriptions aren't blocked or set to private, you'll make it onto my Thank You to Subscribers page, which probably isn't coming up right now, but it'll be back soon, so be on the lookout for that. And before we go, we must do the video shout out! Today's video shout out goes to Tom Girl Gamer. Tom Girl Gamer was literally here when I first started my channel. It was very early on. Tom Girl Gamer, Danny, thank you so much for all of your support. Thank you for still watching and commenting on my videos. I really do appreciate it. I think that Tom Girl Gamer was one of the first bigger YouTubers that followed me. I remember like seeing like, I don't remember at the time, I think you had like 3,000 subscribers. I was like, oh my gosh, somebody with 3,000 subscribers is following me. And it was like the greatest thing in the world. And you were one of the inspirations that I had to continue kind of improving my channel and gaining subscribers. And I always kind of was like, you were like that person that I was really trying to reach for. So thank you so much for being an inspiration to me, and thank you so much for all of your support. I really do appreciate it. I get so excited every time I see a comment from you, just because, you know, you're still here and I notice it and I appreciate it. So thank you. And everyone else, I hope you guys have an amazing day, and I will see you guys later. Bye.